Wow, wow, wow. Guess what they got?
These people's Spanish-speaking person.
Huh?
The Spanish-speaking person could not spell Esquivel.
Yeah. I bet you the patio's in direct sunlight because it ain't really that cold.
Hey guys, how are you doing today?
Good.
Hi. How's your day going?
Hi.
So you guys can have either breakfast or lunch, whichever one you guys want.
There was something that I wanted for breakfast, but I can't remember what it was.
Like a sandwich or like fries?
I think it was like a pastrami bagel or something.
Pastrami bagel? Oh, a pastrami egg and cheese?
It might have been the hot pastrami, I don't know.
Because that's lunch. But the pastrami egg and cheese, it's like
a,
you can have it on a bagel or a roll. But if you want like the pastrami sandwich, which is the lunch one, it's a Reuben.
I'll have the, but you know what I really want? It's the bratwurst Chicago style.
Okay, of course.
Yes. You like the corned beef sandwich.
Order me one of this. We don't need that schedule.
Huh?
Because he's not here
ordering one. What? I thought you ordered the corned beef sandwich already.
Could you put the corned beef sandwich?
I haven't put it down. You want one? Okay. Yes, sir.
And me,
regular Coke? For the sides, it's potato salad, coleslaw, or baked beans. It comes with a sandwich. Awesome. Regular Coke and a diet. Got it. Any fries or anything else with that today?
What didn't they have? Some fancy fries or something?
We have like Belgian fries, or schnitzel fries.
I have some Belgian fries.
Sure.
Daniela, she
says
it's
under
the
checks
out when
she.
Oh, yeah.
Is,
and for here, guys?
Do it?
For here?
Yes.
Okay.
Do it?
What's the name?
Joey.
Joey?
Yes.
Awesome. That'd be 3846, please.
All right, here you go. Where?
Yeah, I'll do it, Joe.
Thank you.
Here you go, son. Here's your napkin for the Chubbington. Your napkin for up here. Hold on. And put a straw in your coat.
Okay.
Speech, face, Zoom, face near top right, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 57 seconds, speech off.
What do you think about this new adventure on independent living?
I love it.
What is the goal? What do you eventually want to do?
Be able to sustain myself.
Hey, honey.
Andy.
We're out here at that killer sandwich shop, the hole in the wall I was telling you about, and they really have some great sandwiches. Would you like us to bring you one?
They have Reubens. You've had them before.
Here? She came here with us?
No, we brought her one.
Oh. Would you like a sandwich? What kind of sandwich you want? You want a Reuben? Okay. All right. I know we got a French fry. I mean, I got chips at the house, so I'll just go for a Reuben today. All right?
Hey, Mommy.
Hello?
Guess what we're starting with next week?
Here, talk to her.
Mm-hmm. Guess what we're starting with next week? Making sandwiches. I know you're gonna love that. Huh? Oh, well. Eventually I'm gonna be able to do it by myself. What you doing? Okay. I'll learn how to do the laundry too one day. I love you, Mom.
See you, honey. You all right? All right. Talk to you. See you soon. Bye. Why is she crying?
I don't know.
What'd you tell her that made her cry?
I'm starting making sandwiches next week.
have to give me a piece of face. Thank you for letting me. And I didn't get, I don't consider that getting sanctus. I'm merely laid beside you. Say, this is a good flyhead. Got me more orifices. Booked. All right?
Oh, you got a flathead.
I did. But I didn't get a piece of feet. I didn't get any medicine from my hurting bone on my right leg.
You got it yesterday, though.
Yeah, I'm really that close to me. I love you, son.
I love you, too.
Huh? I don't see a Reuben anywhere. Oh, wait a minute.
They do. They have them. Unless they took them off the menu.
Yeah, they do have Reuben. You know what I'm waiting for?
What, Daddy?
Down the road till you get pro fishing. How many meals? How many wishes? How many meals? How many wishes? How many stuff that you were wanting I had made for you?
Lots of stuff.
I'm waiting for you to make one for me. Mm-hmm.
Oh, it was?
Yeah, I gotta check your ear too.
Okay.
And I'm gonna check it with that lip, not with a thing that scratches, but with a thing that you can screw the stuff out of. Because it's really, you can smell it again. Almost finished. I like a Reuben to go. Are those things cannolis?
No, they're not. I wish they were.
Okay.
They're cinnamon bagels. But yes, sir. So
what are
a
Reuben
sandwich. Cinnamon bagels.
At the bottom?
Oh, so these right down here, they're sausages.
So oh, they look like cannoli from here.
Oh, yes, sir.
Oh.
Tower of French fries.
Mm-hmm. Mm, they got curry ketchup on them. You know, curry ketchup is a very common thing in Berlin.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm gonna put this over here. Cause I need her to cut that sandwich in half for you.
Huh?
A new one on me. I did not know that the Germans were into curry. Your French fries are to your right. Mm-hmm. Right there.
They are. But only in like Berlin it's really common.
All right, Giuseppe. They cut them in half for you. Make sure you press it hard down, because it's... How is it?
Wonderful.
What?
Mm-hmm.
Come through your mouth.
Huh?
Take smaller bites, dude. Those fries are good.
Yeah, they are.
I helped myself.
Did you ever get the tickets for the beer festival?
Nope.
Are you going to?
Yep.
Huh?
Yep. Yo, that's a $200 night, right?
Mm-hmm. We did it last year, and it was a whole lot of fun.
What? Went down the wrong road.
Thank you.
there is a knife protector that goes over your fingers just like that. You got irons and stuff. I'm gonna order you one of those.
Okay. You gonna get them beer tickets?
This one. By the time we have a beer, it's $110. And then we have the food outside, we would have spent $200 on it, you know. I'm just telling you.
Mm-hmm. And then guess what's basically across the street from it?
What?
Prohibition.
You know what that means?
Huh?
You know what that means? It's more than a $200.
Isn't Beaver cheaper than a $20 night?
Beaver is cheap. You know, we've still got a huge half of a hamburger. Are you taking it home?
Mm-mm.
Are you full?
Mm-mm. French fries are good.
Yeah, they are. Hey, here. think I'm going to take half of my sandwich home.
Sausage?
Uh-huh. You know, I thought I said, that's a weird-looking hamburger. It was sausage.
Yeah, it's a bratwurst.
Okay, hold on. I'm putting this back together. Shit. Well, like we say in Germany, scheiße.
Yep.
thinking about, Joe.
What, Daddy?
How much I love you. Let me have one of those toothpicks.
Those what? Toothpicks.
I'm taking my sandwich now.
Daddy, I thought you said something.
I love you.
I love you too, Daddy. Is a house made bratwurst.
Yeah, I can see it right there.
How do you know that, the receptionist at MAB speaks Spanish.
Celeste Ortega.
Oh. Okay. Maybe she was Mexican. She misspelled it on purpose because she thought we were Guatemalan.
Actually, there's a lot of Esquivels in Mexico.
There are?
And the most Esquivels I ever saw.
Wow.
Were in Costa Rica.
Don't they have a bit of a rivalry with Guatemala? I kind of heard somewhere that there was kind of like beef between them and the Guatemalans because they said
it was fluffy.
Yeah. I mean, I know, you know, there's beef between the Dominicans and the Haitians. They can't stand, the Dominicans can't stand the Haitians. Why?
Because the Haitians are black. They conquered the Dominican Republic.
Ah. You know, a lot of people think when they hear, when people talk about migrants and stuff and the migrant crisis here, a lot of people think it's just people from Latin America, but it's everybody's coming across that border.
Yep.
It's everybody coming across.
Including some sleeper cells.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if a lot of people realize that. I bet you there are a lot of people that think it's just Central Americans. Javier did it the right way, though.
Yeah.
Well, see, the difference between him and half of the people coming across there is that he had a legit case for asylum.
Yeah. And Javier is an asset. He's getting ready to buy a house. He's paid taxes. He makes us better.
Mm-hmm. Don't you have to have, like, when you come here, you have to have a sponsor, right?
Yeah. Well, you know, you have my brother.
They do that so that, they don't, so you don't just get turned loose. That's what they got, a bunch of people with no place to go and nobody to go to, and then... Hmm?
I was going to ask you if you were Finnish, but obviously
big amount of Chicago goodness that fell on the tray. That's what makes it a Chicago dog.
That's it. That's it.
I'm surprised this place didn't make it on the top 100. John G's made it.
What are the criteria?
Reviews, good reviews, and what people say about it. Uniqueness is probably one of them. And more so reviews and you know, like Currygate having 5 stars and 300 reviews or something. Just for the original location. They made number 14.
Well, you know what I think happened?
What?
Bibbidi Bibbidi, when he has nothing to do, he starts adding good reviews to his own restaurant.
Nah, I don't think so. The Curry Gate doesn't has no reason to do that. Trust me, that man's got two locations. He's got another spinoff restaurant, the Arboretum. He's got one opening at Monarch Market. He doesn't have much time to do no bullshit.
He's got a restaurant at the Arboretum.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, he just opened it.
Damn, I need to talk to him about some t-shirts.
Called Curry Junction.
Yeah, he's probably got some bibbity-bibbity guy making t-shirts.
Maybe. In that type of bullshit. Wouldn't you say so?
Yeah.
And you don't need to.
You need to go wash your hands?
Huh?
You still got one napkin in your tummy, right? Mm-hmm. That's all the other ones you've used up.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Here's your coat. Give me that napkin right here. Thank you. Thank you. there.